Well, hey guys, what's up? It's your boy, one and only AR Legends. And yeah guys, today I am back with the next part of what if Naruto was neglected by his family and had the powers of Majin Buu. So yeah guys, hopefully you guys enjoy this part. And if you guys have not seen the previous part of this series, please check them out as well. And hopefully you guys will like them. So before starting this video, I would like to make a request to all of you guys who are watching this video. If you guys are new to this channel and if you guys have not subscribed yet, please guys do so. It would be a lot helpful to me. And yeah guys, I have also put the link of my Instagram within the description below. So please follow me on Instagram as well. So without any further ado, let's start the video. Last time we left off as we saw that how the news about the defeat of all the four nations spread like wildfire, as most of the cages were furious when they heard that how they not only their Jinchuriki were defeated like they were little pets, and on top of that most of the shinobi died within that mysterious empire, the continent, as most of the elemental nations felt threatened by that. While on the other hand, news about this mysterious empire also came to Konoha as Minato along with the whole Third Hokage, Jiraiya, Tsunade went to, you can say, the council room, where they told them about it, as Danzo was the first one to, you can say, suggest that they should attack, you can say, this mysterious empire, seeing that it has come out of nowhere. Surely they do not have a stabilized shinobi or defense system, and on top of that they must not be that technically advanced and things like that. But to his surprise, as well as the most council, Minato as well as Jiraiya announces what actually happened to the other four nations who tried to attack it, as most of the council felt threatened by it. So they decided to, you can say, take a different approach for the situation, as Minato decided to send Jiraiya on a, you can say, diplomatic mission so that they can actually meet the leaders together and they can come up with some, you know, some kind of treaty or something like that. And Jiraiya also had a secondary mission to plant some type of spies within the nation so that they can actually get some information about it. While on the other hand, Jiraiya tried his, you can say, when he entered within the empire, he saw that how his chakra network was all over the place. He could not even, you can say, summon a toad or something like that to, you can say, leave a spying toad or something like that, as it was simply not possible. As Jiraiya thought it must be some kind of Fujitsu or something like that. As Jiraiya saw that in most of the places there was some, you can say, written M all over the place, so he was escorted to the emperor, as he saw that he had his personal council, as most of the members had chakra reserve that of cages easily, as well as several S-rank shinobis, especially, you can say, Zabuza, who has been declared as an S-rank missing nin within the bingo book, and he had really gotten promotion. While on the other hand, you can say, many of the shinobis, they have a lot of chakra, I mean a lot of it. Even Jiraiya was able to sense chakra from the civilians who had equal to that of Genins easily. So Jiraiya was really surprised by that, as well as it was quite intriguing, as he finally met with the emperor, as they had a bit of discussion, as Jiraiya was figured out a one person that was said to be from a, you can say, distinct clan, as Konoha was the one who eradicated the clan only, as well as many other nations, because they were too powerful. This clan was known as the Ranmaru clan. This clan said to have the blood of a dragon, and they can, you can say, use the nature energy like it is nothing, and even being able to transform by using the, you can say, nature energy. Though their method is different from the sage mode, but still they can still utilize it, therefore making themselves a lot stronger. As Jiraiya was utterly shocked, because he was more than sure in all of his travels he has never heard about, you can say, of any of the survivor of this clan. While on the other hand, he finally met with Naruto, while on the other, though he did not knew that it was actually Naruto, because Naruto was simply had a simple, let's say, a disguise on him. So yeah guys, that was the last part where we left off. So they decided to meet within the Chunin exam. So yeah guys, that was the last part where we left off. So let's begin the video from here on. As Jiraiya was rushing towards Konoha, he had a lot of information that he has to provide to Minato as quick as possible, as he even forgot about his secondary mission. To be honest, there is little he could actually do about, you can say, finding Naruto within the empire, because his chakra network was all over the place when he entered into the place, as if something was stopping him from using his chakra reserves. Even when he tapped into the senjutsu, he could feel the smirk on the faces of those people, as if they already knew what he was trying to do and allowed him as Jiraiya felt a presence lifted from his shoulder when he came out of the empire, as something was watching him, something was putting pressure on his shoulder, stopping him from doing whatever he pleases. Even when he tried to use secretly the summoning jutsu, it did not work whatsoever. As the Babusa, as well as most of the members who were around him, he could feel a bit of smirk on their faces as if taunting him. As Jiraiya was really surprised and shocked at this point, he did not even feel some, you can say, seal taking hold of him. He was a spy master, damn it. As he rushed towards finally arriving in Konoha, even using his torch to arrive there, while on the other hand Minato was doing his usual Hokage duties. As while on the other hand Minato simply sighed, he has already, you can say, appointed Kakashi to be the teacher for the Team 7. It is going to be Menma, Naruko, as well as Sasuke Uchiha. As this was the whole scene, as after all Sasuke is the last Uchiha because of the Uchiha whole massacre and things like that. So he had to put Sasuke within the care of Kakashi. He was the only Sharingan user. As Minato sighed, his relationship with his family is getting strained by the day. And to be honest, Minato could tell that it is mostly his own fault. Though people cannot, you can say that it's all of his fault. After all, he has gave so many years to train Menma and Naruko. And to be honest, a part of him was disappointed. He was hoping for a prodigy who would have, you can say, taken his name and bring glory to the Namakaze name. But it seemed that Menma and Naruko, they're able to use three tail if they push it to max. Other than that, they cannot use more chakra. Above that, of that of a nine tail, they can use the Rasengan, but they still need a shadow clone and their taijutsu is, you can say, is in the middle. They did not become that strong even, you can say, under the apprenticeship of four S-rank shinobis teaching them. As Minato simply sighed, to be honest, a part of him, you can say, almost felt betrayed or a waste of time or something like that, but he did not say it out loud. After all, he did not want it to, you can say, strain his family relations so much, though he simply shook his head. Now, he was simply hoping for Jiraiya-sensei and the other problem, his first son, who has left Konoha, and his family did not even knew about it. Well, he was the only one who was left out of the loop, since Kushina as well as Tsunade also knew about it, though Tsunade, he did not care about her much, so he did not thought about it. While on the other hand, Jiraiya and Kushina should have told him as he gritted his teeth on that damn the Akatsuki. As finally, he felt the presence as Jiraiya jumped within the window. As Jiraiya looked all around the place as he looked towards Minato. Minato, you have to summon Third Hokage as well as Tsunade and Kushina. I have grave information for you. As Minato raised an eyebrow about it, though he was wondering if he has gotten some information about his first son, but he simply shook his head. So he simply nodded at that. After 2 minutes, Jiraiya, Tsunade, Kushina as well as Third Hokage were present within the room. As Minato looked towards Jiraiya, so alright Jiraiya-sensei, what information did you get? As Jiraiya simply sighed, Minato, I have great information about the Empire. As Third Hokage raised an eyebrow, and what kind of information are you talking about? As Jiraiya simply nodded as he started to go through hand sign and place a hand on the crystal ball of the, you can say, Third Hokage. As most of the people were surprised as Third Hokage raised an eyebrow at that. He knew that, you can say, technique. After all, he was the one who taught it to Jiraiya. So they finally, you can say, the crystal ball started to shine, and finally they could see when Jiraiya entered within the whole Empire, as most of their eyes widened. The buildings, the technology that was being used there was far advanced than the world. It seemed that they have secret alliance with the Snow Country, or you can say new Spring Country, after Kyoki, the true empress has taken over the position as the new ruler. While on the other hand, you can say, they were simply looking towards all of it with awe as Third Hokage and most of the shinobis there noticed that the M that was on most places. As Minato said, Jiraiya-sensei, what this M is all about? Is it some kind of seal? As Jiraiya simply shook his head, I don't know Minato, but I have a bad feeling about it, especially when I entered within the whole chamber. As I simply nodded and started to look towards the whole chamber, as Minato as well as Third Hokage eyes widened when they entered within the place, especially those people who were simply looking towards Jiraiya. As you could even feel the power which Jiraiya felt when he was there, all of his feelings and things like that were also, you can say, operated within the crystal ball. When Jiraiya activated a bit of sage more, as they felt the enormous chakra, as most of them were taken aback from it, as Third Hokage looked to Jiraiya, are you sure about it? As Jiraiya simply nodded at that, of course, sensei, all of them. could be easily considered high A or S rank shinobi easily, only going from their chakra, especially that guy, as they look towards when the person smirked and complimented Jiraiya on his sage mode as their eyes widened when he announces the name of his clan, the Ranmaru clan, as they all knew about the dragon clan. So, they were quite surprised and shocked to see that even Third Hokage had a bit of sweat going through his, you can say, forehead. After all, he did fought the head of the Ranmaru clan and not many people knew about it. He was beaten to a pulp because of the senjutsu mastery the man actually possessed and his, you can say, brutal style, as Third Hokage gulped a little while only then Minato was looking towards all of it, especially when the emperor started to speak, the emperor, when Jiraiya sensed his enormous power, he was taken aback from it with all of these things. And finally the report ended as Minato simply, there was silence within the Hokage office as Minato looked towards him. So what did he tell you, Jiraiya-sensei? As he said, well, he did agree to meet us, but he said that he has things to take care of with other four nations. Hopefully things will calm down, and for that it will require a bit of time, so they will meet within the Chunin exam, since he's gonna let one of his team participate within the Chunin exam. As Minato was taken aback from it but nodded nonetheless. And the shinobi system, as Jiraiya simply shook his head, I did, you can say, request it because I wanted to see their village, hidden village, but it seemed that he told me that it wouldn't be much of a hidden village if they showed it to everyone who arrived within their nation. As Minato nodded at that, it was understandable, as after all, these so-called hidden village are not that much hidden to begin with, but still, he nodded nonetheless, as he said, alright, Jiraiya-sensei. So, this is the report, well then. Have you been to gather the next mission which I gave you? As Jiraiya simply shook his head, Minato, I tried to summon a toad, but most of them had a smirk on their faces and I was unable to summon my spy toad whatsoever. It was quite different. I was feeling as if a pressure was on my shoulder, as Minato simply nodded at that, as he said, alright Jiraiya-sensei, you may take a leave. As just simply nodded at that as Minato looked towards his village. 6 months, huh? Well then. He will meet this emperor, but hopefully it will not lead to, you can say, the new conflict within the elemental nation. The last thing he wanted was that. So he simply shook his head, while on the other hand, finally, within the empire, Naruto was standing as he has his eyes closed as he smirked at that as he looked towards Zabuza, as well as his second in command as he looked towards them. You guys take care of things here. Hopefully the nations will understand that it's not time for them to attack us in such a manner, as Zabuza speak up. So what about them? You know that they will not stop at that, and since they have already attacked us, they know that the diplomacy is out of the options. As Naruto simply smirked, they will not try anything for now. They will wait for the Chunin exam. That is a point where most of the things will start, as Zabuza simply nodded at that. So where are you actually going? As Naruto simply smirked, I can feel all around this planet, as well as above and beyond this planet. They are, you can say, a few thousand kilometers, miles away. I can feel a pretty powerful presence, or actually two presences, trying to move from one planet to another. I'm gonna check it out. As most of them were surprised but nodded nonetheless. After all, they do not doubt their emperor whatsoever. As Naruto had a bloodthirsty smirk on his face. To be honest, he was getting bored here. As he vanished from the ground, shattering the ground. As started to move up and up towards the atmosphere of the planet. And just like that, he finally arrived within the space as he looked back towards his planet and then towards moon. He could also feel some presences on the moon, but to be honest, at the moment he's not interested in it. As he rushed towards, as you can say, pink energy surrounded him, as a smirk was coming to his face as he vanished from the eyes of most, while on the other hand, far away from the earth, two beings were standing in front of a gigantic tree. These people had, you can say, pale skin and eyes that of the Byakugan, and one person had the eyes that of the Rinnegan. As he was standing in front of the tree, who was about to board the final fruit, as he was smirking, and they simply looked towards each other. As these two people were none other than Otsutsuki's Mishiki, the leader here, and Hishiki, his servant, as they were simply looking towards, you can say, the whole fruit that was about to be you can say bloom from it, and soon enough they will bear it and eat it so that they can increase their powers even further. After that, they have to leave this dimension to vent into some other dimension. As they were simply smirking at that, waiting. After all, they have already destroyed the planet. But then suddenly they felt something, a presence that was coming towards them with enormous speed and power, especially the bloodlust. As they were taken aback from it, as Mishiki narrowed his Rinnegan eyes as Hishiki said, "My lord, what is this presence?" As Mishiki narrowed his eyes towards the, you can say, sky. "I do not know, but it is pretty powerful." As Hishiki nodded, "But how is that even possible? The planet, this planet, residents, maybe warriors, but then they were not match for us. And they did not have a lot of power to begin with." As Mishiki nodded at that, "I do not know, but he's coming here pretty quick. He'll be here within seconds, if I'm not mistaken." And just like that, suddenly the whole planet atmosphere changed into immense bloodlust. And on top of that, enormous energy, as Naruto finally entered within the atmosphere of the planet as he was looking around. As he simply chuckled, the utter destruction that has been caused within the planet, as his eyes narrowed towards that gigantic tree that was there. Especially the energy that was radiating from it. It was similar to that chakra energy which increases his magical powers always. As he narrowed his eyes, this tree was absorbing the life essence of this planet, which means that he narrowed his eyes towards the fruit. That fruit possesses all of the energy of this planet, chakra, ki, all of it. As he simply smirked at that, his eyes finally met with two strong presences that was he was feeling. As he looked towards them with a bloodthirsty smirk on his faces, his eyes was changing to that of the rat. And when he noticed the Rinnegan, his smile increases even more. After all, he also possessed that dojutsu. To be honest, it was not too much useful to him, because whatever that dojutsu could actually do, he could do it as well with his magical powers, of course. As he looked towards, you can say, both of them, as Hishiki speak up, "Who are you, stranger? You are not a..." As he looked Naruto up and down, specifically a human. "So, what are you?" As Naruto simply smirked towards him, "Well, I should be the one who asking you this question. After all, two people alone in a destroying planet. Tell me, were you the one who destroyed this planet?" As Hishiki simply looked towards him with a strange expression, but did not say anything. As Naruto simply smirked at that. "Silent treatment, huh? Well then, I'm gonna, let's just say, destroy your mouth in the beginning so that you can scream as much as you can. And after that, I will silence you." So, as I look towards the other person, "You must be the boss here by seeing your demeanor. So who are you guys?" As Hishiki speaker, "We are the members of the great Otsutsuki clan. And we are the strongest race within the whole universe. While on the other hand, what are you? A bug, nothing more than that. You think that you can talk to my lord in that language? Well then, you're gonna pay for it." As he rushed towards Naruto with incredible speed, while Mishiki simply narrowed his eyes, his Rinnegan eyes further, as he was already gathering chakra within his body. The person, the chakra, the power he was feeling from this guy was out of this world. There was no way Hishiki could actually take him on. While on the other hand, but he decided to watch the battle. While on the other hand, Naruto simply smirked as Hishiki was coming towards him. A sword came out of with pure energy of red chakra. As Naruto simply smirked towards him as Hishiki moved his sword, cutting Naruto in half. As he had a smirk on his face as Mishiki raised an eyebrow. He was hoping for to see a battle. After all, the energy he was feeling from the guy. But it seemed that he did not knew how to control his power, or something is out of the way. But Hishiki was smirking, thinking that how he has already ended the battle. But then suddenly he heard, well, "What do we have here? You want to cut me down, huh?" As Hishiki quickly moved his head to see, two parts of Naruto's body were floating within the mid-air. The upper body of Naruto simply smirking towards him. Suddenly, his lower part started to come together to his other body, and finally, a red, you can say, pinkish glow surrounded him, and he was perfectly healed. As Naruto simply smirked towards him, his red eyes boring hole within the, you can say, head of Hishiki, as Hishiki's eyes widened when he met with a punch to his face, and then his whole body felt pain in utter pain, while Mishiki's eyes widened, his Rinnegan could see thousands of attacks were attacking Hishiki within seconds. As Hishiki let out a scream of pure pain and agony, as Naruto grabbed his, you can say head, and slam it into a mountain, shattering it apart. As Naruto was smirking as he grabbed Hisashi even further, throwing him towards Mishiki. As Mishiki gritted his teeth at that, it seemed that he's gonna have a battle within his hands as he looked back towards the tree. The fruit was still boring and it was not ready at the moment. As he gritted his teeth, he had to stall for time, and after that he will eat it, and then he will have a power of a whole planet that should be enough to take care of this monster. As he rushed towards him, as his Rinnegan eyes shining, Shinra Tensei, as he released the, you can say, gravitational energy, which is a lot greater than Nagato, if I must say. As Naruto simply smirked towards him, as force slammed into it, pushing him into a mountain, shattering it apart. As Hisashi did not stop, as he slammed his hand together, as earth started to rose up, as the avatar of the, you can say, a whole gigantic figure stood up from pure earth, as well as hot fire inside of it. As Mishiki started to channel more and more of his chakra, as he put his hand into the sky, as whole mountain started to shiver with pure energy, and on top of that, the meteor started to come from the sky. As Naruto was simply lying down, as Mishiki released all of his energy, as his whole mountain avatar on top of that whole meteor slammed into the ground, as the whole, you can say, figure of the whole stones had a gigantic sword in his hand and slamming it onto the mountain in which Naruto was slammed into. And after some good attacks, he released a gigantic stream of black energy, or black, you can say, flame towards the area, trying to end whoever this guy actually was. But then he started to pant a little, but then suddenly he heard a chuckle as he started to get burst into a whole laughter. And finally, the whole area started to steam upward as Mishiki simply looked upward to see that these, you can say, small particles were coming together all over the place, and it was turning into something big. But then suddenly, the figure of that monster came to light as Mishiki was taken aback from it, as Naruto was simply looking towards him. Well, huh. You were able to actually disintegrate me, if I must say, but that was impressive. Well, if it was not me who actually allowed it, that is, as he was smirking towards, chuckling even more, as Mishiki was taken aback from it. As he looked around, this guy has too much chakra and too much power, as he looked toward the down form of Hisashi, as he rushed towards him, activating his Rinnegan, grabbing his, you can say, minion, and changing it into pure chakra, and started to eat it. As he looked back towards the tree, it was still not ready, damn it. As he started to eat, you can say, his companion chakra, and finally his whole body started to transform. As he looked towards Naruto with his, you can say, red Rinnegan eyes, as he released a force of energy towards him, a beam of pure chakra and energy, as Naruto simply smirked as it collided with him, and boom, a blast occurred, sending Naruto a bit flying. As you can say, Mishiki rushed towards Naruto, trying to attack him even more and more. But Naruto was taking all the attacks head on. As after some time, Naruto grabbed his fist as he looked toward directly into the eyes of Mishiki with a bored expression. You know, I was actually hoping for a challenge, but it seemed that I was mistaken. Before Mishiki could even say something, that how he is a superior being or something like that, he felt a hand going through his stomach as he looked down to see Naruto's hand inside of his stomach. As Naruto bring it out, and within the center, a blast came to his hand. A pink energy was surrounding it as Mishiki looked in pure horror and terror as a boom occurred, blasting his body away and blasting it out, you can say, into the ground. As Mishiki trying to stand up, trying to, you can say, gather some energy. Who are you? As he looked towards Naruto, as Naruto simply smirked with a devilish grin on his face. You know, as for me, I am Naruto, Majin Naruto. As he released his, you can say, suddenly a pink energy, an orb of pure pink energy started to surround Naruto's hand. As he started to get increased in size, it was increasing more, and finally it was that of a size of a mountain. As Mishiki looked towards the energy in pure horror, his body cannot, you can say, sustain. Even if he were to try to absorb all that energy, his body would not sustain, especially with all of his injuries. As he looked towards, you can say, his body, which was already steaming from whatever that blast actually was, it had a touch of magical energy. As Naruto simply smirked towards him, releasing his energy orb towards him. As Mishige tried to grab him, trying to absorb it, it was already too late. After all, magic is something that was out of this world. So, his Rinnegan was unable to process it and absorb it. And therefore, boom! As a gigantic hole was finally appeared within the destroying planet. As I had to look around, to be honest, there was no one alive within this planet. As he looked towards the tree, especially the fruit, which was now ready. As Naruto simply shook his head, that tree, especially that fruit, had the power of the whole planet. So he, just for the good measures, grabbed the, you can say fruit, and looked towards it up and down. But simply shrugged and started to eat it. As Naruto could feel, his energy was increasing drastically. His body, his magical powers were skyrocketing with each and every bite of the fruit. This chakra was changing into his magical powers, and he could feel that how his regenerative energies has also increased, skyrocketed even more. He can even regenerate from his smallest particle of his body if he has more than enough energy to do so. And trust him when he said that he has a lot of energy to do so if he so desire. As Naruto simply look around, as he could feel his energy is even increasing. He could feel his range around the universe was increasing. He could feel many same presences, but they were in different dimensions. He could feel them, and he could feel that he could shatter this dimension and can go into different dimensions if he so desire. As he had a smirk on his face, well then, it seemed that he's gonna have a bit of hunt in this single dimension. And after that, this Uzusuke is jumping from dimension to dimension, from universe to universe, from planets to planets. Well then, run. As he had a smirk on his face, as he vanished from the area, going into some other planet where he could actually feel this presence of these Uzusukes. The strongest race in the universe. Well then, it seemed that he's gonna have to test that theory of theirs with a smirk on his face. While on the other hand, in the Elemental Nation, time has already started to pass a lot quicker, as all the nations were wary of the Majin Empire. They did not know that what to do about this whole situation. While in the Raikage office, the council was looking towards the Raikage. Raikage-sama, we have to do something. We have the most shinobis all over the Elemental Nation. But yet, we were defeated from a, you can say, newly came nation, which has appeared out of nowhere. They should not even have a already stabilized shinobi system or some trade system. As Raikage simply shook his head. I was thinking the same thing, but it seemed that they're pretty powerful. As one of the members stood up, so what should we do, Lord Raikage? Other nations are already laughing at us. As Raikage simply scoffed at that, other nations have also tried. As the other person speak up, we are not talking about them, Lord Raikage. Our main business come from the minor nation around. Our nation and the missions came from them. But if they hear that we were defeated so easily, then they will start to hire the Majin Empire to do so. It is a humiliation to all the four nations, which means that their clients will go to either Majin Empire or Konoha, since Konoha has not attacked it. And from the rumors we are hearing, they're gonna have a meeting within the Chunin exam that are coming within Konoha within few months. As Raikage thought it for some time, he could already tell the mission request has already gone down a little bit, and he was angry about it, but there was little he could actually do about the chaos. So he gritted his teeth at that. It seemed that this was humiliation did not go away as easily as he previously thought. As he simply sighed, his brother was still in the hospital, even with the, you can say, the help of the Biju. His injuries were different from any, you can say, injuries be actually had. That is mainly because Naruto's energy has a hint of magical power inside of it, and therefore Biju's chakra may be powerful, but it is unable to heal it completely. So therefore, it will leave scars. Pretty bad scars on B especially, though Yujito did not have that much, you can say, burnt, because she was protected by B, but she was still in the, you can say, range of the attack. So she was also injured pretty badly, though not as badly as B. As Raikage gritted his teeth at that, his brother was in the hospital because of that damn, you can say, so-called empire. He's gonna crush it. Kumo shall have its revenge no matter what. As he gritted his teeth, alright then, make our Genin teams ready. We are gonna enter within the Chunin exam. As one of the council members speak up, are you sure about it, Lord Raikage? This year, Chunin exam are gonna held in Konoha. They will have advantage. As Raikage glared towards him, this will show the might of Kumo. And on top of that, we shall have an opportunity to get how powerful this so-called emperor is. If he were to come there, I'm pretty sure that Hokage will have a meeting within the Chunin exam, and this will provide us the opportunity to seek what we actually want, which is information about the so-called empire. And if the opportunity presents itself, we're gonna get rid of the emperor and take over as the new emperor within this new continent, the Majin Empire. As they simply looked towards each other, it was pretty good of a plan, while on the other hand, same type of meeting was going on in Iowa. As Tsuchikage was looking towards his council member, as one of them speak up, so what's the plan, Lord Tsuchikage, who simply cannot get this, you can say, humility, we simply cannot get rid of it. After all, after the yellow flag, we are humiliated because of this so-called emperor. So what we should do about it? After all, we are losing missions at great rate because of them. As Tsuchikage nodded at that, I have already taken care of it. Soon enough, we are gonna participate within the Chunin exam, and then we will be given the opportunity to get rid of the so-called emperor. And after that, we will be able to show the world the might of Iowa. And if the opportunity were to present itself, we would be easily able to take over the empire. Because I'm pretty sure that without their emperor, they do not have much strong shinobis. As they simply look towards each other and smirk at that. Why? On the other hand, Meitorumi, the Mizukage, simply sigh. Her, you can say, council was getting overreactive. They were saying that how they should attack once again with more force. And some of them were even suggesting that they should participate within the Chunin exam. And when the opportunity presents itself, get rid of the emperor, since they were the nearest to the empire through water. They should be able to take care of, you can say, the empire as well. But Mizukage already knew who was behind this emperor and who was behind this empire, and she was more than sure that even with the full might of, you can say, Kiri, they would be unable to actually fight him off, especially how powerful he actually is and the rumors which are going around about the whole Zabuza. As she sighed at that, she was pretty young at the time, so, and she wanted to take charge and become the new Mizukage, so she made the mistake of, you can say, framing Zabuza and getting rid of him. But it seemed that he did not die as she previously thought, and now he has joined the empire. And if he is so near to the emperor, there's a, you can say, chance that how he will turn him against them, and they have already attacked the emperor, and especially that kid. As she had a shiver going through her spine, she remembered when he actually came here and how powerful he actually was, being able to take out the forces and even Yagura like he was nothing, just a kid, and destroying him pretty easily. As she simply sighed at that, but she has little, you can say, options here. As you look around, alright then, we are gonna send, you can say, a Genin team within the Chunin exam this year. As one of them speak up, are you sure about it, Lord Mizukage? After all, little Mizukage, after all, this year Chunin exam are gonna held in Konoha. As she simply nodded at that, don't worry about it, I'm pretty sure that Konoha will not try anything. So, they simply nodded at that. But I want to make one thing sure, we are not gonna attack the emperor, as some of them were about to object. You guys have no idea, don't you guys actually see who is actually the emperor? As one of them gulped a little, but we are not sure about it, Lady Mizukage. As Meitorumi simply shook her head, I do not want to risk it. And trust me when I say it, I am pretty sure that who is actually behind it, it is the same kid, which I have already told you. As she looked toward one of her advisor, Ayo, you remember him, don't you? As Ayo gulped a little, but nodded nonetheless. Yes, Lady Mizukage, I remember him pretty well. He was pretty powerful, being able to take out the forces of Yagura. As some of the council members, you can say, simply scowl at that. They were the supporters of Yagura, but still, they held too much important, you can say, position. They simply cannot, you can say, be executed or something like that. So, Meitorumi let them be within the council, as they were the clan heads of some of the clans who supported Yagura of, you can say, bloodline users. So, Meitorumi simply nodded at that. We will get a bit of information about him, and then we will decide what to do To be honest, she simply wanted to have alliance with him, and knowing that, going up against someone like him, especially when the kid was only 8 years old, he was able to decimate an army and take down a cage. After 8 years, how strong he would have gotten, there is no, you can say, way she couldn't actually stand up to him and fight him head on. And if Zabuza were to be there, he would want revenge on her, and things will not go as smoothly as it goes last time, as she nodded nonetheless. As time was passing on, while on the other hand, Mama and Naruto were training under Kakashi. As Kakashi was really proud of his, you can say, almost little brother. After all, they were only 16 and they could already do the Rasengan. And on top of that, they could do the Shadow Clone and some of the other fire and water techniques as well. So they were pretty powerful. Almost, you can say, they were easily Chunin level. While not Jonin to be perfect, but still. Easily, they can easily take on any Chunin within Konoha. Even, you can say, the best Chunins, high ranking, such as Izumo and Kotetsu, even Iruka, who was once in Anbu but decided to take the role as a Chunin. So, they can easily take him on, and if they were to use the power of the Nine Tail, they can even give the many Jonin within village run for their money. And they were only 16 years old, so he was really proud of them and teaching them. Why don't they then? Sasuke Uchiha was also a prodigy, pretty powerful. And Menma, and you can say, Sasuke quickly became, you can say, rivals. On the other hand, he could already tell Naruto had a crush on Sasuke. So, the team was going pretty well. They have just completed a mission within, you can say, Wave Country. Flashback. As they were fighting one of the rogue ninja known as, you can say, Raiga. He was pretty powerful. After all, he was hired by Gato. And he was pretty tough, especially using his lightning affinity within mist, shocking even Kakashi and being able to cut him off guard. While on the other hand, Menma and Naruto were already channeling the power of the Biju. But for some reason, Sasuke's Sharingan as well as his own Sharingan was unable to copy his movement, and he was able to counter it pretty easily. Unknown to him, it was actually Ranmaru, which was on the back of that guy. While on the other hand, he was pretty powerful, using some other low-level Chunins as well for his help, being hired by Gato. So, when Kakashi was about to use his final technique to get rid of him, though doubtful because he was also a lightning user, especially that sword would be able to counter it, suddenly some member arrived out of nowhere and he saw the level of those Genins. They have a headband which was written M on it. As Kakashi even, you can say, told it to Minato, that was not a nice sight, though he simply shook his head, especially that middle kid. He was pretty powerful. He was, you can say, he claimed to be a member of the Ronmaru clan, which Kakashi already knew about. After all, Jiraiya did warn him, and on top of that, he was not any Ronmaru. He had pink hair, and he was the heir to the Ronmaru clan. And his name was Natsu Ronmaru. He had two members of his team, Awashi and E. So, a girl named E, and they were pretty powerful as a Genin, as he saw that when they arrived here, and easily took care of Raiga like he was nothing, as especially that Natsu kid. He was able to take Raiga head on within a sword fight, even being able to, you can say, counter his lightning energy like it was nothing, and being able to take him out so easily, as Kakashi simply shook his head. As he looked towards his team still needs work, especially against the member of the Genins that were there. And especially their sensei, the aura that guy actually possessed, almost scared Kakashi because he could easily tell that guy was a S-rank shinobi. Easily. While, on the other hand, while Natsu, maybe the, you can say, that kid Natsu especially was different from the other. A pink energy was surrounding his body when he started to channel his energy, and after that, it was only, you can say, flashes of pink. And after that, the Raiga was on the ground with several broken bones within his body and a kid within the hands of that Natsu person who was looking towards the kid strangely, especially the eyes of the kid, as Kakashi was confused about it. As he looked towards them, as he said, "Who are you guys?" As you can say, "Their Jonin commander, speak up. Don't worry about it. We were after this Raiga guy. After all, we did heard about him and how he has interfered with one of our missions. So, we simply wanted to take him out. And seeing that, we have also helped you try to save this nation." As he looked towards, you can say, the shivering form of the whole Tazuna. and just simply chuckle at that as for who we are as he pointed towards his headband as Kakashi narrowed his eyes. He has never seen that symbol, but then he suddenly remembered his discussion with his sensei about a Majin empire came out of nowhere and how they're shinobi of their own. As Kakashi was pretty surprised, especially when he looked towards the other three kids, he could already tell they were not chunin or jonin, they were genins. And his sensei has told them that how they're gonna participate within the chunin exam as he gulped a little, especially the aura that was surrounding the kids. This Natsu guy actually possessed a bit of Naruto's energy because he was a member of the Ranmaru clan, the son of the leader, but he was born with, you can say, a weak body. He had a side effect, he was unable to channel the nature energy and therefore he had a default within his gene. So Naruto channeled a bit of energy inside of the kid using his magical energy, healing his body, but that also gave him a bit of Naruto's power essence, so therefore making him a lot stronger than any member of the Ranmaru clan. So one of the strongest, and he could also use a bit of, you can say, nature energy now, a lot greater than even Jiraiya or his father. So he simply smirked towards Sasuke, who was glaring towards him with as much anger and hatred as possible, seeing that they came out of nowhere, defeated the chunin that were fighting against, you can say, Sasuke, Menma, Naruko, and even defeated the main villain that was there. As Sasuke was pretty angry at that, he has also heard about this Majin Empire, but previously he thought nothing of it, but now it seemed that they're pretty powerful. Why? Kakashi simply shook his head. He also gave the report to his sensei, who was, you can say, pretty surprised, and gave Asphar every single bit of the information that he had about the genin, their sensei, and things like that. Though he was unable to identify their sensei because of a, you can say, small hood which he had over his head. As Minato sighed, it seemed that the chunin exam in the future are gonna be a lot interesting. But hey guys, here I will have this part too, because enjoyed it. For the next part, you guys already know the like goal and the comment goal. Please complete that, 300 likes and 120 comments. Do that and I shall upload the next part as quick as possible. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. In the next part, we will see about, you can say, imagine many, you can say, Ususkis and things like that. So hopefully you guys enjoy it. So yeah, peace.